Hello everyone, in today's lecture we shall discuss the working of PLL FM demodulators. PLL demodulators are found in many types of radio equipments ranging from broadcast receivers to high performance communication equipments. PLL could easily be integrated into the radio IC by simply adding a little extra circuitry to the IC. The PLL technology eliminates the costly RF transformers needed for circuits like Foster Sealy discriminator or the ratio detectors. A PLL consists of mainly three blocks: a phase detector, an active low pass filter, and a voltage controlled oscillator. So this is a block diagram showing the three main components of a PLL. Now this is a PLL FM demodulator circuit. So here you can find the three major blocks in the PLL. One is a phase detector, then I've mentioned an active low pass filter. It's a low pass filter with an amplifier, is termed as an active low pass filter, and a voltage controlled oscillator. So before we go into the working of a PLL FM demodulator, we should just see what are the functions of these three major blocks in a PLL. So phase detector produces a DC output voltage which is proportional to the phase difference between the input signal having a frequency fn and the feedback signal having a frequency fout. So here you find that a phase detector has got two input frequencies. One is the input signal frequency which is coming into the detector, and the other one is this feedback frequency coming in. So depending upon the phase difference between the two input frequencies, we find that a phase detector, it produces a DC output voltage depending on this phase difference. Now the second block what we have here is a low pass filter and amplifier. Now this phase detector is basically a balanced modulator which produces two output frequencies, namely the sum frequency and the difference frequency. So now this low pass filter is going to transmit the difference frequencies, and they are amplified, and then it goes as the input to the VCO. So an active low pass filter produces a DC voltage at the output and amplifies this signal. So this is the voltage which we give as the input to the voltage controlled oscillator. Now this VCO, this produces a signal of a certain frequency when no input is applied to it. So this is a voltage controlled oscillator. When you do not have a voltage applied to the input of this oscillator, it gives a signal of a particular frequency. And as you give an input voltage, a DC voltage over here, this DC voltage can vary or shift this frequency to either side. So that is meant by a voltage control oscillator. So these are the three major blocks that we have in a PLL. That's a phase detector, which is basically a balanced modulator, a low pass filter followed by an amplifier, and then this output voltage is given as the control voltage to the voltage control oscillator. A PLL operates in one of the three modes: the free running mode, the capture mode, or the lock mode. A PLL is said to be in the free running mode when there is no input applied to the PLL. So you can see here there is an input. There are two inputs that comes to the phase detector. One is the input, the external input, and the other one is the input that you get from the feedback. So a PLL is said to be operating in the free running mode when we have no input applied to PLL. So when there is no external input applied to the PLL, we say that it is said to be in the free running mode. Now when the input signal having some frequency is applied to the PLL, what we find here is that this voltage controlled oscillator, it starts to change the frequency. So VCO, it is a voltage controlled oscillator. It is normally giving a signal of a certain specified frequency. So as the input voltage applied to it varies, we find that this frequency of oscillation also changes. That is how we get the name voltage controlled oscillator. So we say that when you have an input voltage applied to it, we'll find that there is a control voltage coming to the input of VCO, and it can be seen that this output frequency of the VCO begins to change, and the PLL is now said to be operating in the capture mode. That is, it is trying to capture to the incoming signal stream. This is a feedback loop. It is trying to see that this change is minimized. So it's trying to capture to the incoming signal frequency. Now that is what is meant by the capture mode. The third mode what we have is the lock mode. That is, the output signal frequency of the VCO, it changes continuously until it becomes equal to the input signal frequency. That is what is happening in the capture mode. Capture mode is trying to change the output frequency so that is equal to the incoming signal frequency. And when this frequency, output frequency of the VCO becomes equal to the input signal frequency, we say that the PLL is operating in the lock mode. So these are the three modes of operation of a PLL. One is a free running mode where no input. The second one is a capture mode. You have an input and VCO is trying to change its frequency to match to this input. And the third one is a lock mode when the VCO frequency, output frequency has become equal to the input signal frequency. Now we are going to explain how this PLL can be used for FM demodulation. So this is one application of PLL as an FM demodulator. So here you can find that when we want to use a PLL as an FM demodulator, the input frequency that you give over here to the PLL is the frequency modulated input. So if you're giving the frequency modulated input as the external input frequency, you can find here that if you are configuring your PLL in this way and you take the output from this amplifier, you can find that this output voltage is the demodulated output or the modulating signal. So you give a frequency modulated input and you find that your output is the modulating signal, and this modulating signal is exactly same as the control voltage for the VCO. So this is the feedback that we give for the VCO. So this demodulated output is same as your control voltage for the VCO, which is exactly same as your modulating signal. So now we are going to explain how this particular circuit or how this PLL works as an FM demodulator. That is, if you give the input as a FM signal to a PLL, how do you get the modulating signal at the output? Now we can see how this control voltage is equal to the modulating signal. So let us see over here, we have got two inputs to the PLL. One is the incoming signal frequency. Now here in our FM demodulator, PLL FM demodulator, the incoming signal is the frequency modulated output. So this FIT here is the frequency modulated output. And we know that frequency modulated output can be represented like this. It is variation of frequency. So FC, which is the carrier frequency, plus K into EMT, where K is the frequency sensitivity of FM modulation. And EMT is the modulating signal. So this is the expression of FM modulated wave, which is very clear, which we have learned many times. So this is one of the input, the one external input that we give to the FM demodulator, PLL FM demodulator, is the frequency modulated input. The other input is from the feedback, that is the output of the VCO. Output from the voltage control oscillator is given by FVCO. So this is the feedback which is going to the PLL. So this is equal to, what is this equal to? This is equal to F0 plus KVC0 into VCT. That is, it is a voltage control oscillator. In a voltage control oscillator, I've mentioned that voltage control oscillator, when there is no input voltage applied to it, it has got its free running frequency. You can set the free running frequency for your VCO. So when you have a voltage applied to it, according to the voltage that you apply, according to the strength of the voltage that you apply, positive or negative, you find that this frequency of oscillation varies. So this here you can find the variable oscillations that come as the output of a VCO. So F0 plus K, this is the constant, the frequency deviation constant, and this is the control voltage that goes to the VCO. So the input to the VCO is VCT, the DC voltage, and the output from the VCO is actually this frequency FVCO. So here we have shown here the two inputs to the PLL. One is the FM input, the other one is the output from the VCO. So now VCO has a normal free running frequency plus the change in the frequency according to the input control voltage that goes to the VCO. Now, when VCU frequency tracks the incoming signal frequency, which means that when the output of the VCU, FVCU, this frequency becomes equal to the incoming signal frequency or the FM modulated wave, in that case, we'll see what happens. So when FVCU is equal to FI, we're just equating the two expressions, what we had written earlier. So F0 plus KV0 VCT is equal to this. Or from this, we are writing the expression for the control voltage VCT. VCT is equal to, we get this expression, FC minus F0 plus KEMT divided by KVC0. So now here, we can make the VCU, we can tune the VCO so that the free running frequency of the VCO is equal to the carrier frequency. So if we tune a VCO such that the free running or frequency of the oscillator is equal to the carrier frequency, in that case FC becomes equal to F0. So this term will go, and you can find here that the remaining terms we have is K into EMT. K is our sensitivity for the FM modulation, EMT is a modulating signal, and this is the frequency deviation constant for the VCU. So KEMT by KV0. And here again, if you just look into this, we can find that the control voltage for the voltage control oscillator, VCT, the input for the voltage control oscillator, which is actually the output of our PLL FM demodulator, this is equal to K by this. So K by KVC0. K is a constant. This KVC0 is also a constant. So this term is a constant multiplied by EMT. Now we have got the expression for VCT. VCT, we have got it as a constant times the modulating signal. Now if you find that this VCT is actually your demodulated output, so that's the output of the PLL FM demodulator. So we are just coming back to the equation again. Therefore, the output or the control voltage VCT of the voltage control oscillator is proportional to the constant times the modulating signal voltage. Or what we find is that this VCT is the demodulated output. So this is how a PLL can be used as an FM demodulator. Let us see the advantages of PLL FM demodulator. Now, PLL FM demodulator is usually considered relatively as a high-performance FM detector. The main advantage you can say is that the linearity is an advantage for this demodulator. This PLL FM demodulator has got high degree of linearity. That is, the PLL will be able to operate over a wide bandwidth, normally much wider than the bandwidth of the FM signal. Now, the second advantage is that it is insensitive to amplitude noise. As the PLL tracks the frequency of the incoming signal, it provides high degree of AM noise immunity. That's one other advantage. So compared to the previous demodulators, what we have seen, these two points, we find that the other demodulators, what we have seen, they were sensitive to amplitude variations. Therefore, we had to use amplitude limiters prior to those detectors. But that is not required in the case of a PLL FM demodulator. The third advantage is that ease of incorporation into ICs. That is, PLLs are very easy to implement in an integrated circuit, and you can find that PLLs are available as ICs, and hence the technology is easy to implement. And one of the commonly used PLL is the PLL IC is LM565. So you might have used that in the lab. So this is another advantage of the PLL FM demodulator. Now, another advantage you can find is that the manufacturing costs are less, because as the PLL FM demodulator lends itself to IC technology, only few external components are required to complete the FM demodulator. You don't need to use an inductor or an RF transformer as it's required for the other demodulator circuits. So these are some of the advantages which makes PLL FM demodulator more preferable or the commonly or widely used FM demodulator circuit. To summarize, in this session we have discussed the working of PLL FM demodulator. We have also seen why PLL FM demodulators are preferred in high performance communication equipments. Thank you.